job. No pain, no gain.
Hey, Tommy, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
All right, let's play some ball here. Was your third baseman in or out of the game?
You're 10 runs ahead. Why don't you lighten up?
Why don't you go powder your nose?
Tommy, you okay? These are just kids. Does sportsmanship count for anything?
Oh, get off the field. Women don't belong on the playing field.
Especially as coaches.
What?
What did you say?
Who the hell do you think you are?
It's jerks like you who don't belong in the field.
Yeah, the storm is way too big. It had to be all three of us.
Yeah, well, it serves him right.
Come on. Woo!
Anyone for seconds?
Oh, okay. But two is my limit.
Yeah, two's my limit, too.
Right. At a time.
Raymond Gentry asked me.
The headmaster?
Hey, it's about time. Well, I finally gave him an opening, and he took it.
The important thing is that you like him. You do like him, don't you?
Yeah. No, I do. I do like him. He's not bad looking. You know, he's very charming. Doesn't exactly make my heart flutter, but...
He's single, employed, and breathing.
Well, I never said he was perfect.
Wonder if we'd even know the perfect man if he came along.
I would. Because he'd be gorgeous. But he wouldn't act like he knew it. A casual but elegant dresser.
With fiery eyes.
Somebody who actually listens. You know, a guy who I can just relax with and be who I am.
Me, I want honesty. Somebody who doesn't play games. A man I can look straight in the eyes and not see through.
Mysterious.
Creative.
Talented. Why don't we just conjure him up? We conjured up the rainstorm, didn't we?
Oh, that was different.
Very different. You can't snuggle up to a rainstorm.
Oh, you are not serious. You don't think we have that much power, do you?
Let's find out.
Suki, think about it. Where does our power come from? Well, that's where he'd come from, too.
The dark side. To the perfect man, may he come into all our lives. Perfect man.
Of sugar. I'm throwing together a Kirsch meringue torte. Have you ever had one? They're orgasmic. Anyway, I've got enough Kirsch and cream of tartar to feed an army, but not so much as a single cube of sugar. I can't find anything. All my stuff is still in boxes, and they're labeled upstairs and downstairs. Can you believe it? Movers. I hate moving. It's the worst pain in the ass in the world. Well, I suppose you've been through it. Kitchen through here?
They have sugar at DiBello's. It's right down the street.
I know. Wonderful market. I understand they deliver. Darrell Van Horn, I just moved in, almost next door.
He needs sugar.
Oh, well, I'm Jane Hollis, and this is Alexander Spofford. Of course you can borrow a cup of sugar, Mr.
Van Horn, call me Darrell. Is this your house? It's great. Somebody has a trunkload of pesos.
Oh, well, I don't have a trunkload of pesos. I used to have a trunkload. Well, what I mean is I used to be rich. My husband was rich. I got the house in a divorce settlement.
One cup will be five.
Oh, sorry.
Well, nobody likes a divorce, but a place like this sure sweetens the pill somewhat.
Guys,
I'm interviewing the unmarried head of the archaeology department at Harvard. Which dress should I wear?
This one is perfect. You know, nature played a cruel trick on the animal kingdom, giving all the beauty to the male of the species. Got it right with the old Homo sapiens, though. Don't be afraid of a dress which says, look at me. Darrell Van Horn, your new neighbor.
Suki Ridgemont.
Delighted.
Darrell came over to borrow a cup of sugar, even though DeBello's is right down the street and it delivers.
So you're a reporter?
Yes, I'm a reporter for Channel 8.
I loved your interview with the housing commissioner. You really nailed him to the wall. Bureaucrats, what can you say about them? Nothing. Well, that's precisely my point. You ought to interview me sometime. I love a good interview. It's so intimate. Just the two of us going at it one-on-one.
Why would anybody be interested?
Well, for a start, I just bought the biggest house in Beacon Hill. And I've led a fascinating life. But what I want to know is, what's the story here? Three beautiful women all living together under one roof.
Well, Jane couldn't afford the expenses by herself, so she invited us to share the house with her.
Good idea. So where'd you all meet?
Don't tell him all of this. We don't even know him.
Eastwick?
Oh, yeah. A lot of strange goings-on down at Eastwick.
Not anymore.
Well, ladies, I gotta run. But I tell you, we're gonna be great friends. Just like the four musketeers. Me for you and you for me. I'll send my man Fidel over with some torch. You'll love it. You've never put anything quite as good in your mouth before.
I can't believe what we've done. We have got to send him back.
What are you talking about?
Isn't it obvious? We conjured him up. He is everything we asked for.
Well, he's not. He ignored me completely.
I'm getting ready for work.
Suki, he is going back. And so should that dress he picked out.
Well, what do you think?
He ignored me completely.
Last coin down. Save it for PE.
Right, horns up. Huh? What are you doing here?
I'm here to help you. Besides, I felt like I ignored you completely this morning.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about? Help me with what? You know, it's the headmaster. Listen, you have to get out of here.
Van Horn. Sorry I'm late.
Not a word of it, Gentry. I'm sure I must be early.
I see you've met Miss Hollis.
Yes, at breakfast this morning. The tort came out great, by the way, thanks to your sugar.
Oh, he's my neighbor.
Ah. Van Horn has just made a substantial contribution to the school's music department.
Ah, the Steinway! I knew him, you know. Oh, actually, I knew one of the sons. May I?
Yes, please.
You know the wonderful thing about music? It cuts right through to the emotions. Clarifies everything. Reveals the truth.
You're going to regret this.
Oh, I love a piano! Imagine what I could have done with lessons.
You hit him?
Yes, I hit him.
It isn't funny, Suki. Everything is ruined. I've lost my job. Any chance of a relationship with Raymond is over. And it's all Daryl's fault.
Why blame it on Daryl?
Because Raymond wouldn't do something like this.
That's it. We have got to send him back before he causes any more damage.
Maybe you're jumping to conclusions.
Oh, I can't believe it, Suki. He's already got you wrapped around his finger.
You're just jealous.
Don't be ridiculous. I am not interested in Daryl.
Well, I am.
Oh, that's par for the course.
Well, at least I'm in the game.
Yeah, playing every position.
Guys.
Stay out of it.
I can't believe your attitude.
My attitude?
Yes,
look at
your attitude.
Stop it!
I mean, look at you. You're at each other's throats.
We can't let him come between us.
All right. I know conjuring him was my idea. But we all had a little too much to drink. It was a mistake. But we can put the genie back in the bottle.
We all three have to agree or it doesn't work.
We need a plan. Agreed?
Agreed.
Agreed.
Yes.
Hi. Is Daryl in? I wanted to thank him personally for the delicious tort.
Wonderful surprise. Come on in. I'll give you a tour. I can't wait for you to see the house. I love going through other people's homes, don't you? It's so personal. This is what I've had to settle for as a living room. I don't know where I'm going to hang everything.
Are these all originals?
I admit I overpaid. What the hell are you going to do? Think of those lucky fools who took an early Rembrandt off his hands for the price of a bottle of brandy. Now, here's the genius of the bunch for my money.
Rubens?
That's how women used to look, Alex. Round, voluptuous. Now they all want firm thighs and washboard stomachs. You're a sculptor.
How did you know?
The hands. The hands are a giveaway. I love art with tactility, art that's meant to be touched.
Miss Suki Richmond on the phone for you, sir.
Oh, an embarrassment of riches. Tell her I'll call back.
Yes, sir.
No, no. Go ahead, take the call. I'll be fine.
Thanks. Look around. Make yourself at home. I'll take it in the den. Yes,
feeling we were going to wind up in the bedroom, Alex. How do you like it?
Nice. I've never seen black sheets on a bed before. What are you doing?
Just being as direct as I know how. That's what you prefer, isn't it, Alex?
I'm not so sure.
Why is it that men and women can never just be honest with each other? Why does there always have to be this mating dance? Will she let me do it with her? Should I do it with him? Why can't they just get down to business and do it? What do you say, Alex? Shall we get down to business?
What are you talking about, Daryl?
You know, Alex.
I have to,
Go home?
Yes.
Why? Who's waiting for you there? Where has going home ever gotten you?
It's where I live. Stop it. Stop it. I've got to go home.
You wouldn't believe some of the lousy assignments I've had in my life, Alex. London during the plague years, for example. I mean, give me a break. I was glad to be sent away that time, but I like Boston. I'm happy here. I hope you're not thinking of sending me back.
Oh, I really couldn't say, Daryl.
But you wished for me, Alex. You and Suki and Jane. Well, here I am.
Goodbye, Daryl. When it dries, it will crack and turn to dust, and so will Daryl. We all have to be in agreement on this.
When it dries, he dies.
It's what we have to do.
I'll get it.
Hello?
Yeah. I am surprised to hear from you. Right, okay. All right, bye. I don't believe it. That was Raymond.
Gentry? What did he want?
He wants to talk to me about giving me my job back.
See? Things are looking up already.
Jane, I'm so glad you could come.
Well, I'm the one who appreciates the opportunity, Raymond.
Come in, please.
Thank you.
I can only imagine what you must think of me. I don't know what came over me.
Well, it wasn't your fault.
I'm not like that, you know.
No, of course you're not.
You had every right to slap me.
No, I didn't.
You did.
I want to apologize.
Shall we put this silly little incident behind us, then?
Yes, please, let's.
Good. Now we can talk about getting you your job back.
Wine and fireplace routine.
Nothing's more relaxing than a good glass of wine.
Oh, come on, Gentry. Tell her what's really on your mind.
It makes you lightheaded, and it's that much easier to get into your pants.
Beautiful.
What did you say?
I said this wine comes from France. It's an excellent vintage. Look, we really should talk about your job.
Yes, I think so.
I know you need it. And I want you to have it back.
Tell the truth, Raymond.
But first, you have to sleep with me.
Why are you saying these things?
Did I say sleep? I meant eat. We should have dinner sometime.
Do you think I'm an idiot?
Tell her about your other conquests.
Look, Miss Shepherd, the art teacher, she slept with me. Miss Wasson, the math teacher, she slept with me too. What makes you any different from them?
Higher self-esteem.
Good one, Jane.
Jane.
Raymond.
Jane.
Raymond.
You need Raymond. This job. Think about it all for a minute.
Raymond, that locked door thing, that was good. That was thinking ahead.
Van Horn, how the hell did you get in here?
I knew it.
Oh, I tried to warn you about this guy.
You were right.
Where did you come from?
It's a long story, Ray, but I want to tell you something. Another time, another place, we could have been good friends. I think you have enormous potential. Let's go.
I don't even know if I want the job anymore.
Well, it's your decision.
Joe, what's wrong?
Somebody has baked a bad batch of cookies. Take me home.
Hey, what's going on?
Hurry up!
What's the matter? What happened?
Oh, my God.
You girls did a thorough job, that's for sure. It's too bad. We were gonna have such fun together.
What are you doing?
I
can't go through with it. We're killing him. Is that what we really want?
Yes. No.
I don't know.
Put it back. It's too late to change our minds.
Well, maybe it's not.
Hey, we agreed.
Well, that was before.
Even if we wanted to undo the spell, we don't know how.
Well, maybe we could just...
Oh.
It's turning to dust. Daryl.
Oh, you beautiful, wonderful, fantastic, magnificent girls. I love you.
Hey, what's the matter?
We're just a little surprised to see you.
Somebody didn't want me to go. Maybe it was all three of you.
I'm famished. I thought we'd have a little light supper, a little champagne, a little caviar, some flowers for the table, and of course, the piece de resistance, some of Fidel's famous chili. You see how it's going to be from now on, a little fun, a little mischief, and lots of good food.
We're going to have to keep an eye on you, Daryl.
Still have the power to send you back.
Girls, I'm at your mercy. I happily place my fate in your hands.
That chili does smell good.
Yes, and it's such a casual meal, I thought we might have it in front of the TV. What's here? We watch a late movie.
Forget it.
TV reception stinks.
Haven't you noticed? How did you do that?
Hocus pocus.
NBC's all-new Friday lineup for summer continues as Mark Harmon and Marlee Matlin turn up the heat in the critically acclaimed Reasonable Doubts, followed by Law and Order, with stories ripped from today's headlines, tonight on NBC's all-new lineup for summer.